Hi, everyone.
Hi.
How are you all doing?
Hi. Good.
Good, 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 good to hear. So first, I'm going to start off by just greeting everyone and saying hello, hello, everyone, and welcome, welcome, welcome to this wonderful, wonderful online experience. It's a pleasure to be with you all, and I know that you're going to have an amazing time with me tonight, and I look forward to reading my story with you all and you kind of getting a feel of the character named Jackson in the story. And I want to welcome all of my YouTubers, and actually I want to welcome all of you who are online with me tonight. So are you ready to have some fun?
Yes.
So again, thank you so much for being here. And who would have known that the Olympics would not be occurring right now? So think about it. Right now, athletes would have been traveling all over the world to come together in Tokyo to compete at the Olympic Games. Isn't that kind of amazing?
Yeah.
Yes, yes, they would have been there. So, you know, since we can't have the Olympics this year, we decided to come together to do the Olympic experience. And of course, today you are going to do story time with an Olympic gold medalist, Mary Wineberg. So I'm so happy to have you. And before I begin, I'm going to start off with a couple of, I guess, event rules. And I don't really like to call them rules, so I will say event expectations, okay? So one, I would love for everyone to possibly mute themselves. So there's a little button there that you can mute yourself so that I am able to, you know, make sure that you guys can hear me very well, very good. And so that everybody else can have an amazing experience, okay? And my next little rule or expectation is if you have something to say, you can always give me a thumbs up or a nice little wave. So let's practice. Thumbs up, everybody. Thumbs up. Yes. And a nice little wave. Awesome, 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 awesome. All right. And after that, I would like, if you want to participate, and let's say I may ask a question, I would love for you to also give me that wave so that I know that you want to ask a question, okay? So you're probably wondering, who is this lady on this screen, right? I'm going to tell you all about who I am, and then I want to know about each and every one of you. So I'm going to start off. My name is Mary Wineberg. I am a 2008 Olympic gold medalist from Beijing. I currently live in Cincinnati, Ohio. So you are in my home right now with me in Cincinnati, Ohio. I ran the 400 meters in Beijing, and I also ran the 4x400 meter relay. And the 4x400 meter relay, that is when you take a baton and one person runs one lap around the track as fast as they can. And then they pass the baton on to the second person. Then the second goes to the third, and the third goes to the fourth, and so on. So that is a little bit about me, okay? So I want to turn it on to you. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of go across the screen and see here who would like to go first. And if you'd like to be the first person, you can kind of do a nice little wave, but you have to be able to tell me your name, where you're calling from, okay? What your favorite color is, and if you could participate in the Olympic Games, what sport would you do? So I'm gonna start off. My name is Mary Wineberg. I love the color pink, and I also love the color gold. And if I'm calling from Cincinnati, Ohio, and if I could do a different sport in the Olympics, I would do gymnastics. Okay, who would like to go next? All right, I see Talia here. Talia, go ahead and unmute yourself, and then go ahead and answer those questions. Favorite color, where are you calling from? What would you do in the Olympics, okay?
Okay, my name is Talia. My favorite color is gold. And I'm calling from Akron, Ohio. And if I could participate in the Olympics, I would do synchronized swimming.
Yes, synchronized swimming. I love it. I love it. I love it. Thank you, Talia. Who is next? Let's see. Let's see. I think I see a Ellie, but Ellie, I think that there is someone else there. So let's check out for you guys. Who do you have with us today? And I'm going to write these names down too, so I can make sure I have everybody.
I'm Ellie Howe. I'm from Columbia, South Carolina. This is my son, Aiden Howe, and his very best friend, Caleb.
Hi. And did you say Caleb?
I did.
Okay. Aiden and Caleb. All right. Go ahead, guys, and go ahead and answer that question for me. favorite color, where are you calling from, and what sport would you participate in the Olympics if you could?
My favorite color is black. If I was in the Olympics, I'm from South Carolina, and if I was in the Olympics, I would do synchronized swimming.
Ooh, synchronized swimming. That's a good one. All right.
Hello, I am Caleb.
Caleb. Mm-hmm.
And if I were in the Olympics, I would do, I think I would do track.
Ooh, yes. Good answer. Good answer, Caleb. And then did you tell me what your favorite color is?
Red.
Ooh, all right. All right, let's go on down. Karis, what would you do? And tell me, where are you calling from? What's your name? Where are you calling from? Favorite color? And what sport would you do in the Olympics?
Okay, so I'm actually here. This is like Karis's computer. So my name is Cara Hawkins. I'm from Cincinnati, Ohio. My favorite color is blue.
Ooh.
And if I were in the Olympics, I'd be a gymnast.
Ooh, a gymnast. I love it. I love it. All right. What about you?
My name is Karis Hawkins. I'm also from Cincinnati, Ohio. And my favorite color is black. And if I were to be in the Olympics, I would be a gymnast.
Ooh, I love it. I love it. I love it. All right, let's go over to Cheryl. Cheryl, who do you have with you tonight? Go ahead and unmute yourself. Tell me your name, where you're calling from. And I see you have two computers, so I'll do Cheryl number one.
All right. Cheryl. I have my grandkids here with me tonight, and we're calling from Springfield, Ohio.
Awesome. Do either of them want to tell me their favorite color and what sport they might want to participate if they could in the Olympics?
You have a favorite color?
Pink.
What was that?
Pink.
Pink. Pink. And what's your first name?
Olivia.
Olivia. And then Olivia, who else do we have next to you?
Hayden.
Kaden. All right, let's go to the next square. All right, who do we have with us?
The older cousins.
Okay, older cousins, first tell your first name, where you're calling from, what's your favorite color, and what sport would you participate in the Olympics?
My name is Blake, and I'm calling from Springfield, Ohio, and my favorite color is orange, and if I did an Olympic sport, I would do...
Yeah, we're getting a little bit of feedback, I think. Sorry, I couldn't hear you guys. And I think if you're sitting right next to each other, it might have some feedback on it. So what did you say again?
Your turn.
My name's Brooklyn. I'm calling from Springfield. My favorite color is teal. And
awesome.
If I was in the Olympics, I would do long jump too.
Awesome. And I'm going to go with, I see there's a Gabby here. Gabby, tell me, what's your name? Where are you calling from? Favorite color and sport that you would participate in?
My name is Gabby. I'm from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Ooh, Brazil.
Yeah, so the last Olympic Games was here in Rio. I was very proud. Yes. My favorite color is yellow. And if I do an Olympic game, maybe basketball.
Ooh, basketball. I love it. I love it. I love it. All right. Did I get everyone? Oh, Jen. I'm sorry. I didn't see you right there.
That's
Jen,
okay.
Can you share with us?
Hi, I'm Jennifer.
Hi.
And I'm calling from Miami, Florida. My favorite color is purple. And like I heard from many people, I would also do gymnastics and I love the floor. And we purchased this because it's my partner's birthday tonight. So this is our way to celebrate him. He just went to get something to drink, so he'll be back. So
awesome. Happy, happy, happy birthday.
Yeah.
And then do we have, is it Marcia?
Yeah, it can be Marcia or Marcia.
No,
that's fine.
Marcia. Is it Marcia?
Yeah, that's fine. Marcia.
Marcia, tell us a little bit about yourself, too, before we begin.
I'm connecting from Rio de Janeiro, just like Gabby. Ooh. Gabby, actually, we know each other, so I'm super happy to see her here. My favorite color is white. And if I were in the Olympic Games, I would play soccer.
Soccer, very good, very good. And I think I have someone else here. Is it Tasha?
Tasha Villanueva.
Oh, Tasha.
And then it's Alex.
And what is it, Alex?
Yeah.
Hi, Alex. How are you?
Good.
Can you tell me your favorite color? Where are you calling from? And what sport you would participate in the Olympics in?
Okay, so what's your color? What's your favorite color?
Yellow.
Yellow.
Where are you from?
California.
Awesome.
And then what sport would you like to participate in the Olympics?
Running.
Ooh, I love those answers. Well, thank you guys. Thank you for sharing. And if I missed anyone, please let me know. So again, we're going to do the thumbs up if I ask a question and the answer is yes. And if you want to participate and you have something to say, you can also do a quick wave. So you're probably wondering, with this whole story time and kind of with my children's book, why did I decide to write a children's book as an Olympic gold medalist? There's a couple of reasons. One, I wanted to write a book that children could relate to. And in this particular story, I talk about a little boy who goes after some, you know, setting goals, and he has to learn that he can never give up. So I struggled in the beginning of my career before the Olympic Games. I struggled with not winning races. I didn't win races at all. And there were moments that I thought that I was a loser, and I felt like I couldn't accomplish or do anything. And I wanted to write this book. And then as a teacher, I'm around students all the time. And I love that students are very competitive. Raise your hand if you're a competitive person or student. You like to win, right? We all like to win. But I found that the students would get so angry, they would get so mad, and they get sad and upset because they didn't win. And I wanted to write a book that would teach a life lesson and not only share my experience from the Olympics, but also be able to relate to kids and even adults, because I know that there are some adults on the call, and also all of our YouTube watchers as well, that maybe there's something that you want to set a goal towards. And maybe if you don't win or accomplish that goal, you might feel bad about it, but I don't want you to feel bad at all. Okay. So I think we're ready to get started. And so I'm going to begin to read my lovely book, I Didn't Win, but I have two things that I want to ask of you. One, as you can see in my background here, I'm sitting on a very big, comfortable blue chair, and I'm going to sit back and I'm going to relax. And you know, like how when you're at school or in an office meeting or building and they tell you to sit straight up and make sure that you're paying full attention. Well, guess what? Today you can relax. You can lay down. You can sit back. You can go like this. You can do this. I want you to feel totally relaxed, and I want you to be able to enjoy my story. Okay. So thumbs up if I feel like everybody's ready to go, and then I can start. If you have a snack that you'd like to grab, some water or something to drink, feel free. And I hope that you guys enjoy. So I am ready. It is called I Didn't Win. Jackson is excited about the upcoming county fair. And through his journey, he learns how to set a goal, how to accomplish it, and that in the end, it isn't always about winning. This book will challenge young readers to learn about determination, believing in themselves, and knowing that no matter what happens in life, they can never give up. All righty. Jackson sprang up in his bed, excited about the new day. Today was the day of the county fair. Everyone knew that the county fair would bring fun, food, games, and lots of excitement. He quickly got dressed and walked to the door, hoping that his parents might be up. Seems to be very excited there. Jackson rushed into his parents' room and jumped onto their bed. Mom, Dad, get up. Today we are going to the fair. Jackson, said his dad, you scared me and the sun is not even up. Yes, Dad, I know, but today is the day of the county fair, as he reached over to nudge his mother. If you look on this particular page, and I'm going to have you ask, or you can kind of do a little wave here as I ask this question, where do you think this story might be taking place? There's a clue. Where do you think the story might be taking place? Talia, where do you think?
Cincinnati, of course.
And why do you think Cincinnati, Talia?
Because above their bed, you can see a sign saying Cincinnati.
Yes. Cincinnati. Very good. Very good. So make sure that you got to watch throughout the story. There's going to be little things here and there that I'm going to kind of point out and point to. But I wanted to include Cincinnati into the story. So very good. All right. We will get dressed and ready to go, Dad said. I'm going to first run downstairs and make a cup of coffee. Jackson did not like the smell of coffee and couldn't understand why his dad liked to drink it every single morning. Jackson tried to patiently wait until his parents were dressed and ready. He paced back and forth. He was ready to go. The sun was coming up. Jackson knew his mom didn't really like the fair. She didn't like dealing with the bugs, the long lines, and the smell of animals. She agreed to go because she knew Jackson loved the fair so much. If you notice in this picture, Jackson has a little dog there. How many of you have a pet of your own? And you can do a simple thumbs up if you have a pet, thumbs down if you don't have a pet. So we can kind of go around and see. Oh, so I have some pet lovers. Some of you don't have pets. Oh, okay. Finally, everyone was dressed and ready to go. Dad paused and reminded Jackson that they were forgetting their lunches. Dad, are you serious? Why do we need to pack a lunch? The fair has the best food ever, Jackson questioned. Dad quickly reminded Jackson that the fair food was expensive and unhealthy. It seemed like every time they went somewhere, they would have to pack their lunch to save money. Ugh, when I'm rich, I'm never packing lunch. I will just buy food at the fair, Jackson said. Well, when you are rich, you will have every right to do that. But until then, do you want turkey or ham? His dad asked. Turkey, please, Jackson groaned. Which sandwich would you choose? If you would choose turkey, put your thumb up. If you would choose a ham sandwich, put your thumb down. Let's kind of see. Oh, okay. Got a couple of turkey and ham. And I guess I should have asked who would choose neither, because maybe you don't like either of those. They piled into the cart and drove toward the fair. Jackson's anticipation grew as the Ferris wheel came into sight. He rolled down his window and could already smell the funnel cake. He could also smell the manure of the farm animals, but he was too excited to care. They finally arrived. Jackson had a blast riding the rides, viewing the animals, and playing the games. He even saw some of his friends from school having a good time. He started to get hungry. Mom, Dad, can I get a corn dog and a funnel cake and an icy? Asked Jackson. Dad reminded Jackson of the lunches they had packed. Let's walk around a bit before we head to our car for our coolers. How many of you like fair food? Raise your hand if you like fair food. I love the fair food. Jackson started to hang his head, and it was at that moment something caught his eye. That was it. A dream come true. The flyer laid on the ground, sticking out of the dirt in a nearby rock. Fastest kid in the county contest. Winner receives a coupon for a free corn dog and icy. Look at this, Jackson exclaimed. The fastest kid in the county contest. Can I enter? He knew that he was one of the fastest kids at his school. Now maybe he could get his corn dog and icy by winning the race. Jackson was excited. His parents walked over with him and he checked into the race just in time. The race starter lined everyone up and she spoke loudly into the microphone. On your mark, set, go! The crowd started to roar and the kids were off. Jackson took off and ran as fast as he could toward the finish line. He was neck and neck with two other kids and he gave it everything he had all the way through the finish line. How many of you have ever ran in a race and you just knew that you were the fastest kid? Maybe, yeah, Aiden, good, awesome. He won the race. Jackson was so happy he beamed with joy. The race starter congratulated him and presented him with a coupon for a free corn dog and icy. She also told him that by winning the race, it qualified him for the fastest kid in the state contest to be held in July at the state fair. Wow. Jackson couldn't believe it. He ran over to his parents and he said, Mom, Dad, will you take me to the state fair to run and the fastest kid in the state contest? Well, we will have to check our schedule, Jackson. But since you did qualify, we will make every effort possible to take you, Dad said. As Jackson rode home from the fair, he stared out the window and daydreamed what it would be like to be the fastest kid in the state. I want to win the fastest kid in the state contest, he whispered to himself. He decided to say it a little louder so his parents could hear him. Well, said his father, it sounds like you just set your first goal. What? What's a goal? Asked Jackson. I'm going to ask you guys to give me an answer to if you know what a goal is. If you know what a goal is, raise your hand. All right, Aiden, go ahead. What's the goal?
Like a goal is like something like, say you start off like, you're trying to get faster and faster and faster.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, something you want to achieve.
Yes, so something you want to achieve. Okay, does somebody else have an answer? Yes. Kara?
It's like something that you want to, you know, accomplish and that you set for yourself.
Awesome. Those are all great answers. You guys are, you're pros at this. Next page. A goal is something you decide you want to accomplish or do, said his father. And once you set a goal and decide what it is you want to accomplish, then you work toward achieving it, Mom chimed in. So how do I work toward winning the race at the state fair? Asked Jackson. His father started telling Jackson about when he was in high school and what it was like to run track. He told Jackson all about how they would practice their technique, work on speed, and train their bodies by running workouts. His dad reminded Jackson that training wasn't easy. I'll help you put together a plan, said Dad. For the next few weeks, Jackson worked very hard to prepare for the race. Almost every day he did something to improve his running. Jackson practiced his running form. He ran sprints and up and down the street. He even did jumping jacks to work on his coordination. He wanted his friends to see that he meant business. I think he looks really serious here. The day of the state fair finally came. Jackson was nervous and had a funny feeling in his stomach as his parents drove him to the fairgrounds. Once they arrived, Jackson didn't know if he wanted to race anymore. How many of you have ever had an event that you got really nervous about? You got really, really nervous that you wanted to not even show up for it, or you wanted to just crawl underneath a rock, right? The other kids looked very fast, and there were so many spectators in the stands to watch. There was even a special guest at the race who had won an Olympic gold medal. Her name was Mary Wineberg, and she was the celebrity starter. Mary called for all the kids to come to the starting line. Jackson thought maybe he would go hide in the bathroom, but he found the courage to walk over to the start of the race. I want to wish you all good luck. Do your best, and after the race, come and see me at my booth for a chance to hold an Olympic gold medal, said Mary. Runners, please take your place on the starting line. You can do this, Jackson whispered to himself. On your mark, set, go. And the kids were off. Screams filled the stands. Jackson was running as fast as he could. His legs were moving faster than they had ever moved before. He tried to push even harder, and he gave it everything he had, but he did not win. Jackson finished in sixth place. He felt so disappointed. He could feel a lump forming in the back of his throat, and he tried to hold back his tears. He left the track and rushed behind the stands so no one would see him. Jackson sat crying. I'm a loser, he said. I'm a loser. What's wrong? Said a small voice that caught Jackson off guard. He looked up and he saw two girls staring at him. I'm a loser, Jackson said. Why would you say that? Asked the taller girl. Because I didn't win, said Jackson. Well, my mom always says that losing is something that happens, but it's not who you are, replied the girl. Jackson screamed to the girl, your mom doesn't sound smart. Did that sound like something very nice to say? He immediately felt bad for what he said. My dad also says the same thing as my mom, so I think you're just upset right now, said the girl. Look, we're going to go get our mom. she will know what to say. So Jackson continued to sulk, kicking his feet at the pebbles, and before he knew it, the girls were back. He couldn't believe it. Their mom was the starter of the race. She was the Olympic gold medalist, Mary Wineberg. He got up and he continued to stare. "Hey there, lovely. What's wrong?" she asked. Jackson was speechless. "So my daughters told me that you were back here crying and that you called yourself a loser. Is that true?" she asked. Jackson started to stutter. "I didn't win the race. I wanted to win so bad, and I worked so hard to win, but I lost." "Well, you sound like a success to me," said Mary. "How can you say that? I set the goal to win, and I didn't even come close." "That sounds like a loser," said Jackson. "My dear, you're incorrect. You are definitely a success." Jackson looked even more confused. She continued, "Look, you told me that you set a goal and that you worked hard to achieve it. Reaching your goal is not what makes you a success. Having a goal and working to accomplish it is what makes you a success. It's about not giving up and doing your best." Jackson didn't know what to say. Mary asked him, "Did you work hard to accomplish your goal?" "Yes," whispered Jackson. Mary helped him back to the track and reminded Jackson that he could be satisfied with the result no matter what place he finished. She reminded him that when she had run professionally, she had lost almost every race that she had won in. "Did you know that I went to the U.S. Nationals 4 years in a row and came up short before I accomplished my goal to finish top three in the 400 meters and to make the USA team?" Jackson listened to Mary continue to tell all about the downfalls that she had in her sport and also how she struggled with believing in herself. He was amazed by all that she was sharing. She never gave up on her dream. Just at that moment, Jackson's parents came rushing down to the track. "Jackson, we were looking all over for you," said his father. "Great job in the race." Jackson was starting to feel better, but wondered about one thing. "You're not sad that I didn't win?" he asked. "Jackson, it would have been great if you would have won the race, but we're so proud of how you competed. I could tell that you gave it everything you had and you did your best," said his dad. "Jackson, come give me a hug," said his mother. He wiped his eyes and gave his mother a big hug. Jackson thanked Mary for coming to talk with him. He got her autograph and got to hold her Olympic gold medal. On the way home from the fair, Jackson once again stared out the window. He was deep in thought, going over the day in his head. Although he was still a little disappointed that he didn't win the race, Jackson realized that it had been a good day. So, hey, that's the end of the story. So I'm going to now ask you guys, what do you think might have been the lesson, or what would be something that you could learn, like Jackson learned from the story? Let's see. Blake, go ahead. Oh, you didn't have an answer, Blake? Anyone else? Brooklyn? Either person, what do you think the lesson would have been from this story?
I don't know.
You don't know what the lesson would be? What do you think the lesson would be? I'm going to call on someone else. Who thinks? Anyone have a wave for me? Talia, what do you think the lesson of the story is? And then I'm going to give you the answer, obviously.
I think the lesson of the story is, like, you don't always have to win. Like, trying again and again makes you, like, know by your mistakes, and it makes you know what you need to do.
Exactly. Does anyone else have anything else that they want to add from the story with Jackson that they think? Awesome. Well, you guys did a great job. That is exactly the moral and the lesson of the story, is that you can never give up. And even though you may not win, it doesn't mean to get really, you shouldn't get upset, you shouldn't get mad, you should just kind of breathe and let it go, okay? So I have something that I would like to do with you all, and it's going to be a little bit of some exercises, kind of like from Jackson's point of view, okay? So I wanna thank you for listening. You guys did an amazing job. And before we do the exercises, I do wanna ask a question of, what are some goals that you want to accomplish? Because like in the story, Jackson's goal was to be the fastest kid in the county, which he accomplished. Then his next goal was to be the fastest kid in the state. And he didn't quite get there, but we never know, he might try again. So let's go around and I'm going to ask you guys to participate for me and tell me, what are some goals that you think that you might want to do? And it can be anything. It can be in sports. It can be in anything that you're interested in. So I'm going to start with Karis and Kara. What are some goals that you have in mind?
So some goals, first, my name is Kara, just to, because lots of people call me Kara, but
Kara and Karis, yes.
Okay, so some goals I had in mind were like, putting on, well, for 2020, this might sound like a little silly, but I wanted to put on lotion every day because I never put on lotion before.
Those are important things. Those are things that matter.
And then my second goal was to make $1,000 in my business.
And what's your business?
It's a lip gloss business.
So I have a young entrepreneur. Very good. So you'd like to make $1,000 in your lip gloss business. Awesome. All right, we'll go with your sister. What's the goal that you have?
A goal that I have for 2020, well, I made it like in 2019, but now it's 2020. So my goal was to build a business. I have built a business, but I just have to get it settled. Also, a goal is to work out more because we don't really work out that much and we eat a lot of junk food.
That's good. So definitely two great, great goals. I love it. I love it. Thank you for sharing. Talia, what about you? What are some goals that you have in mind? What is something that you want to accomplish or do?
I want to get a little better at math before school starts.
Okay. Awesome. I love it. All right, Olivia, what's something that you might want to do or what's a goal that you might want to accomplish? And then I'll also ask Brooklyn next to you and see.
Maybe to start practicing for kindergarten.
To start practicing for kindergarten. I love it. All right, I'm going to go to Aiden and Caleb. What are two goals that you guys have for me? What do you think?
One goal for me is to start getting paid on streaming and playing games.
So another entrepreneur. Very good. All right, Caleb, what about you?
Nothing really.
Nothing just yet. You're still filling it out.
Better at science and social studies.
Awesome. I love that. All right, Brooklyn and Blake, do you guys have anything that you have a goal that you want to try to accomplish?
Maybe to keep my room cleaner every week.
Keep your room clean? Okay. And anyone else?
Blake, would you like to say something? I don't think he wants to say something.
And that's okay if he doesn't. All right. Do we have anyone else? How about Gabby? Gabby, do you have anything that you are working on or do you have a goal that you have in mind?
Definitely now visit my boyfriend that he lives in Georgia and he doesn't live here. That's my only goal that I have right now.
That's your only goal. That's a good goal.
And I can't. All right.
And you can't. All right. Was there anyone else on here that I did not get? Oh, yes. Marcia. What's your goal?
Well, during quarantine, I start learning how to play the guitar.
Ooh.
So my goal is to play 20 songs by December.
Ooh, that is an excellent goal. Well, awesome. So it looks like you guys are off to a great start, just like with Jackson. So really quick, before I get into sharing some things about my Olympic journey, and then you guys will get a chance to kind of ask me any questions that you want about my journey to the Olympics and even after and how I became an author and different things like that, okay? So I just wanna do a couple of exercises with you all. So let's all stand up for me. Yay. We're gonna get active here. And I think this is someone's goal. They said they wanted to exercise more. So very good. So you can say that you worked out with an Olympic gold medalist. So I'm gonna ask for you guys to participate with me and tell me who remembers what were some exercises that Jackson did in the story. And if you have an answer, give me a wave. What was one exercise that Jackson did? What do you guys think? What do you guys, what do you have? Olivia, what do you think he did? I see some lips moving there, but I can't hear you. Does anyone remember? I think there were a couple of stretches. There was something else that he did. Yes, Aiden, I think I see your hand. What do you think?
He did jumping jacks.
He did, he did. So first off, I want us to, we're gonna stretch our arms. So bring your arms over for me and stretch, 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 stretch it over. Yes, and we're gonna switch. We're gonna bring it over to the other side and we're gonna stretch, 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 stretch. And we're gonna gear ourselves up. We're gonna gear ourselves up for this, all right? And now we're gonna do those jumping jacks. So we're gonna do five of them. Here we go, and give me really good jumping jacks. One, two, three, four, five. All right, we're gonna do some high knees because Jackson had to work on his posture and his running form. So you're gonna get your knees up, get those knees up, and I'm gonna turn a little bit for you here, turn back around. And most of all, Jackson had to have really good running form, so he had to be a really good sprinter. So I want you guys, we're gonna start off kind of slow, jogging in place. And then we're gonna go really fast. We're gonna go really, really, really fast. I wanna see how fast can you go. How fast, how fast, how fast, how fast, how fast, how fast, how fast. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. And slow it down and slow it down and slow it down. And awesome. And we're gonna come back. You're gonna take your seat here. And hopefully that wasn't too much for you guys. And I'm gonna now show you guys my race from the Olympic Games. And so while you're watching the race, I'm gonna kind of break it down, tell you everything that was happening. Then when we're done, you get to ask me any questions that you want. So hopefully you guys have some good questions, right? Thumbs up. Cool. All right, here we go. Here's the race. So imagine you're an Olympic athlete. You're going to the Olympics. You're full of adrenaline and you're also nervous at the same time. You're lining up on the track, and in this particular race, it's the women's 4x400 meter relay. There I am. I know that I have to run the first leg for Team USA. They're depending on me to get out of the blocks and give my best. We're running against Russia. We're running against Jamaica. And there are some other teams as well. So I can remember when the person said, runners on your mark, you get down into those blocks, and you kind of block everything out. So imagine there's 95,000 people in the stands. That gun goes off. I'm in lane four. I'm running against the best of the best in the world. And all I can think about is I have to finish, and I have to finish strong to pass this baton on to the second person. So we passed it just even in about first. It goes to the second leg. Her name is Allyson Felix. She's running. He gives us this lead. He passes the baton on, and I'm screaming on the side to my teammates, like, go, go, go. And I want them to get there, and I want them to get there as fast as they can. I'm still screaming. He gets past. I get really nervous, and then I say to my last leg, you got to get out there, and you got to give it your all. So in this race, he could have easily said, you know what, I'm going to give up. We're in second place. I don't know if I have it, but she had to dig really deep. We all have to dig deep. And as you see, in this particular race, we end up winning. So she crosses the line. Team USA wins the gold. And every time that I see this race, I get so emotional, and it's like I was just there. I feel the same emotions, and I was so happy to be able to be on the podium, hearing the national anthem, getting the medal wrapped around my neck, and being able to stand there and be proud of this wonderful moment. So as you guys can see in that video, I had a wonderful medal, and I wanted to show you guys the medal as well. So this is a Olympic gold medal. And on the back of this medal, since the Olympic Games were in China, they decided to make the medals, the inside, jade. And so this medal, I cherish this medal so, so, so much, but I also enjoy having the opportunity to share it with you guys. And also, this is a baton. It's not the actual baton from the race. I really wish that I could have kept that one, but this is the baton that we use that when we're running as fast as we can and we're passing it to the next person, what do you think you don't ever want to do with this baton? Who thinks they know? Yes. Caleb, what do you think? And Aiden, what do you think?
Drop it.
Yes, you don't ever want to drop this. That is very important. Don't drop the baton. And as you can
running, you don't want to accidentally throw it.
Yes, and you don't want to accidentally throw it. And if you can see behind me, that is my actual uniform that I wore in the Olympics. And then I also have another one. This is the one that I wore in the prelims because you have a couple of different rounds in the 4x4. So this is an official USA uniform. So yeah, that's kind of a little bit about my race. And I will tell you all that I was so happy once the race was over. I was so nervous like Jackson. I kind of wanted to find a bathroom in the stadium to go hide in. But do you think that I could have done that? No, I had to be very brave and I had to make it happen. Exactly. And so, yeah, at the Olympics, I got to meet some amazing people. I got the chance to meet Kobe Bryant. I got a picture with LeBron James. I got to meet Venus and Serena Williams, the big tennis stars. And I met so many gymnastics individuals and swimmers. It was an amazing opportunity. So going to the Olympics, it allowed me to become the person that I am today. It allowed me to be able to inspire you guys and thanking you guys for being here with me today. And now I'm going to open it up that you guys can ask me anything. You can.
You're muted, by the way.
Can you hear me now? Did you guys at least hear all of that? I'll sum it up. So what I'm going to say is that I want you guys to be able to ask me anything. You can ask me about being an author, about writing the children's book. You can ask me about going to the Olympics. You can ask me anything. So who wants to go first? Who wants to be first? First to the line. All right, I'm going to go with Caleb. Caleb, you are on question time.
What year did you start the Olympics?
So I started running the Olympics in 2004. I tried out the very first time and I didn't make it. I didn't make it. And I had to wait 4 more years and I had to push myself to try out for the new goal of training for the 2008 Olympics. And then I finally made it the second time around.
That's actually neat.
Yes, it took a lot of hard work. Yes. My lovely Hawkins sisters, go ahead. What's your question?
Who inspired you to like be an athletic like person, or like who did that? Who inspired you?
So who inspired me? I originally started running because a friend of mine in elementary school invited me to come out to the track team. And so that's how I got started. But when I really realized that I had a talent and that I was really good, my coaches inspired me. And there were some famous runners such as Wilma Rudolph who inspired me, and Jackie Joyner-Kersee. And I was just also inspired by all of my Olympic teammates as well. I got a chance to meet them and I got a chance to learn so much from them as well during the Olympic Games.
When did you have, like, when did you want to start? Like, when did you think that you were going to be a great track runner?
Yeah, that's a good question. When I was younger and probably about your age, I didn't want to go to the Olympics. I didn't want to be an Olympic star. I didn't really know what it would take. So I will say probably into college, I sat down and I said, you know what? I think I'm kind of good at this running thing. I would love to try to train for the Olympics. And then that's what inspired me then. And that's where I set that goal. And like I said, it took me about 8 years to get to it, but I got to it and I'm so happy. Talia, do you have a question?
So how did you make it into the Olympics?
Ooh, that is a good question, Talia. How does someone make it into the Olympics? And this can be for not only for track and field, but for any sports. You have to have this big event called the Olympic Trials. And at the Olympic Trials, you have to be the best of the best on that day. So think about it. You could be the best in your particular event, But if you're not the best on that day in that event, you miss out on making the Olympic team. So yeah, it's the big Olympic trials. And for me, I placed second at the Olympic trials and I was able to secure my spot in the open 400 and then also run in the 4x4 relay. Are there any other questions? Yes, Aiden.
Did you draw the pictures in your book?
Ooh, that is a good question. So here's the story about the pictures in the book. I really wanted an illustrator who would draw Jackson the way that I want, and I wanted them to be able to capture myself, and I also wanted them to be able to capture my children. And so once I found the illustrator, I fell in love with her because she provided vivid, colorful pictures and really allowed for the scenes that I wanted to be put onto paper. So yeah, I was very happy with her. Did you like the pictures?
Yeah.
Awesome, awesome. Yes, any other questions? Who else has a budding question for the Olympian? And again, if you have one, you can just do this one. Yes, go ahead, what's your question?
I have a question. Like after not making to the first, like the 2004, what kept you like motivated to like, I wanna do that? Like what happened there?
Now, if you would have asked me that question right after running and not making it, the answer was, no, I'm giving up. I'm not doing this anymore. I wanted to quit. And I realized that, you know, sometimes you have to just keep pushing yourself forward because I didn't know everything about training. I didn't know what I needed to do. I didn't know mentally how to get through those tough moments in those races. And finally, I got all of those things together and I really educated myself about the sport and about my particular race. And I just really said, you know what? I'm going to push myself and I have to believe in myself. That was the thing that I lacked. I didn't believe in myself at first. And so for all of you, you can do anything that you put your mind to and you just have to believe in yourself. Any other questions? Talia?
So how hard was it to train for the Olympics?
Talia, it was very hard. And this goes for everyone on this wonderful video call with me. It was very, very hard to train for the Olympics. I remember the very first time I said, I'm gonna train for the Olympics in 2004. And I thought I could just snap my fingers and it would happen like magic. It didn't happen like that. So I realized I have to train hard. I have to run hard. I have to lift hard. And I had to watch what I ate. I love cookies and cream ice cream. I couldn't have that all the time. So I had to learn to be very disciplined. And I just decided that that was what I was going to do. And in the end, it worked out after, you know, learning the things that I needed to do. Yes, Aiden.
Do you worry about getting sick when it's time to be in the Olympics?
You know, I never worried about getting sick when it was time for the Olympics. I think my major concern was just getting out there and just doing my best. And then I had to realize that, you know what? I've made it this far. My training is good. I'm prepared. I have everything that I need, so I don't have anything else to worry about. Cool. I'll take one more question. Who has one more question for me? Yes, Gabby, what's your last question?
How many times did you train before like, again, how many hours a day?
Oh, maybe 5 to 6 hours because I would have to not only lift, but I have to do little things like yoga as well. And then the running workouts were very extreme and intense. And so, yeah, it was a full-time job to train for the Olympics. And I'm so happy that I was able to do that because like I was able to show you guys, I was able to receive a gold medal for all of the hard work that I did. So, yeah. So thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you so, so much. I hope that I have inspired you to go after your goals, just like Jackson went after his goals in the book, I Didn't Win. And I wanna thank all of my friends on the YouTube channel watching, and I wanna thank all of you guys for tuning in. If you would love to get a copy of the book, I Didn't Win, I also personalize it and I sign it and autograph it to you. You can visit my website, marywineberg.com, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the future somehow through some avenue or way. So yeah, if you guys don't have anything else, that is a wrap. You have just finished up with story time with an Olympian, Mary Wineberg. Please, 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 when you are done, go to Airbnb and give me a 5-star rating so that everyone else can know about this experience and you can share it along with them. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much.
You are quite welcome. Thank you so much.
Very much.
It was a pleasure meeting you all. Thank you. And hopefully I have some aspiring Olympians, right, on the call. Yay.
Bye.
Bye, you guys. Thanks so much.
Bye.